Good morning. My name is Coach Stephen Smith, and I'd like to welcome you to Nimitz High School's observance of Black History Month. As I'm fond of repeating in my U.S. history classes, there's a history to everything. So we'll begin today by examining the history behind Black History Month.
The history of Black History Month begins with Dr. Carter G. Woodson, who is known as the father of Black history.
Woodson was frustrated with the racist interpretations and the exclusion of African Americans in books and conversations that shaped American history.
So in 1915, he helped to establish the Association for the Study of Negro Life and History.
In 1960, the organization launched the Journal of Negro History, which published African American history in honor of the achievements of people of African descent.
In 1926, in the second week of February, Woodson's organization launched Negro History Week to promote the study of Black history in schools and universities.
The Association for the Study of Negro Life and History originally chose the second week of February to include the birthdays of noted abolitionists Frederick Douglass and Abraham Lincoln.
Lincoln was the driving force behind both the Emancipation Proclamation, which ended slavery in the former Confederate states, as well as the 13th Amendment, which banned slavery in the United States. Douglass fought to end slavery and recruited black soldiers to fight in the Civil War.
50 years after the first celebration, President Gerald Ford officially declared February as Black History Month during our country's 1976 bicentennial.
President Ford urged all Americans to honor the too often neglected accomplishments black Americans in every area of endeavor throughout our history.
And that is the history of Black History Month.
Thank you to all our students and staff members. So lastly, here's a quick overview of the rest of the week. On Tuesday, we invite you to dress in traditional Black History Month colors, which are red, black, green, and gold. On Wednesday, we'll have a celebration of African Americans in the arts and sciences. So please wear a shirt displaying a black musician, scientist, poet, or mathematician. Thursday is designated as Historically Black College or University Day, along with Greek Organizations Day. So we invite the staff to wear their Greek letters. We'll also have some information on African American fraternities and sororities, to include my own, Alpha Phi Alpha Incorporated, the first intercollegiate Greek letter fraternity established for African American men in 1906. And on Friday, we'll hold our luncheon in concert with Health and Wellness Day. Thank you so much for your attention, and I hope that we all learn a lot this week.
Good morning, Vikings. Today is Valentine's Day, so today we're going to continue some movies.
Coming in first, Endless Love. Following their high school graduation, Jade Butterfield, a shattered but privileged teen, becomes involved with David Elliott, a working class youth but troubled past, although Jade and David quickly fall in love. Coming in second is See You Soon. An American soccer star managed to find romance after a single Russian mother goes through a career-threatening injury. Coming in third is All the Bright Places. After meeting each other, two teenagers struggle with their emotional and physical scars of their past. They discover that the even smallest moments can mean something.
Well, there you have it, guys. If you have chocolates or flowers, I will be accepting them. Just know. Well, now, Fatima with Viking View.
Good morning, Vikings. I am Mary Kerr Fatima. The Outstanding Community Service Hours contact Ms. Daniels in room 177. Juniors, there's a free SAT math tutoring program on Monday from 4:15 to 5:15. Get ready for your test and earn APV hours. Register now with this QR code. Do you want to join a writer's program? This Wednesday, there's a meeting in room 218.
Thanks, Arisa. I'm Francisco with sports. Vikings, tomorrow the boys basketball team have a home game against Berkner, so make sure to support and show up. As well as the softball team, they have an away game against Hebron. JV starting at 5:30, varsity starting at 7. And the girls basketball team is going to have by district today and tomorrow, so make sure to support them as well. That's all for sports. I'm back to Fatima.
Thanks, guys. Do you still have volunteer hours to turn in? Turn them in before March 4th using this link down below. Also, tomorrow we're gold, black, red, or green. And that's it for today, Vikings. Have a great day.
Please stand for the pledge. Place your right hand over your heart. Ready? Begin.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state, under God, one and indivisible.